This is Howard Hewitt.
Hey, it's Melinda Williams.
Hi, I'm Tony Rich.
Hi, this is Mary Ben-Ari right here in LA, and you're watching Studio Q.
Studio Q Show, now you know.
I think it's important to do things that are bigger than us and contribute to our community, and in this particular case it's coming from where I'm from, which is Israel, and I'm very proud to be here today. I know this institute, the Rambam Institute, I know Haifa, of course, where it's at, and it's really exciting just to think that there is an institute where I'm from that is going to help African-American population in such a significant way.
I mean, when you really think about it, it's like, what's happening in the world today? We have to be physically, mentally sound. I mean, a lot of times people just focus on one area, but your health is very important. You know, the health of the body, and which is the reason why I eat the way that I eat and exercise and all those different things, you know. So yeah, I flew in just for this.
I know how it is when we don't get help, when we don't seek the proper research, when there may or may not be enough data. I know how that can affect us even more adversely. So I think it's important for us to come out and support and raise awareness, continue to raise awareness and continue to raise money and continue to let people know that this is out there killing us in record numbers, and you need to be educated about what it is you can do to prevent it, as well as what you may be able to do, or the help you may be able to seek if you have been diagnosed with it.
Anytime you can support something and make it and bring attention to the whole thing, it's like, it's just like, you know, like they say, the squeakiest wheel gets the most oil, you know, so like, let's make some noise.
My name is Leah Bernstein, and I'm the Associate Director at American Friends of Rambam, and this is Michelle Segelnick, our Executive
Hi.
Director, and this event is a press event to celebrate breakthrough kidney research being done at our hospital in Northern Israel in Haifa, where Professor Carl Skarecki has found the gene that marks why African Americans suffer three and a half more times more prevalent than any other ethnic group. And with genetic research and testing, we hope within 5 years and some fundraising, we can eradicate kidney disease and definitely do some more testing in order to mark why certain people get it and why some don't, and therefore impact humankind and make it a better place.
What's passionate to us is that it's being done in Israel, but at the hospital, and the Jewish people who have suffered for many years, very much like the African American people, and there's a strong connection there. And not only will this research benefit the black community, but also humankind and the way we're going to be treating people who suffer from kidney disease around the world. The implications of this research are tremendous, and we feel it's our privilege to be able to educate people on this and to share this wonderful breakthrough research, and with the help of our friends, raise money to find a cure.
It's a party with a purpose. If I'm stealing that from Tom Joyner, but that's exactly what it is, you know. So you come out, hang out with us on the Martha's Vineyard, very cool, very relaxing place that has significant historical importance to African Americans, and at the same time support a great cause and help us eradicate kidney disease.
I recently lost an uncle, and thank you to in part to kidney disease, and I also lost a cousin to kidney failure, and you know, I know how important it is to our community when things like kidney disease, things like high blood pressure, all sorts of things that affect us disproportionately.
It does hit kind of close to home. My mom was she was diabetic all ever since I can remember, and the last two or three years of her life she was dealing with the whole dialysis situation, which back then, you know, there wasn't readily available as it is now. So, you know, she was kind of bound to, you know, where she was. And so all the technology that has, like, come about since then, you know, I'd love to support so that we can even create more, so even more technology can be developed to make it, you know, not such a cumbersome situation. I mean, as cumbersome as it is as far as a health situation. So, you know, the process to keep people with kidney problems going should be a little bit easier, and anytime they can develop more technology, that's cool.
No matter who you are, you can be confronted with a disease. It just doesn't matter who you are, and that's a real thing to really, really think about and embrace.
I think that African Americans are so affected by this disease and are very rarely the ones who are championing the cause for it and trying to make sure that we have a cure. So I wanted to make sure, and that's only because I think they don't know. They get behind causes like, you know, hypertension and diabetes, and all of those things can impact your kidneys. So then us having the effects of kidney disease on so many African Americans, it's time for them to know how they can help.
Studio.